Hey, St. Mark's. First, I just want to tell you how much I miss seeing you and being with you. And that's one of the reasons it gave me some hope this week to hear from Bishop Benfield about new guidelines for the future of the church for these next few months, and also hear the recommendations of Governor Hutchinson and his task force and staff. So essentially, I just want to update with you. There will be no in-person worship, at least for the month of May. We're going to continue to have online streaming every Sunday like we've been doing now for about 7 weeks. That will definitely continue through May. In fact, one of the things that the bishop has already said that we need to do, and we want to do it anyway, we want to continue online streaming our worship services now and forever, so that anytime you're not able to come to church or not comfortable being in church, you can always worship with St. Mark's and with Christ online via streaming. So we're going to be working this month on how do we make that permanent. Some other things that we're going to be doing this month is we're going to be going through the memo and the checklist provided by Bishop Benfield, and you'll see that is attached as a link to the remarks this week. Invite you to read over all of the thought and the wisdom that our bishop has already put into how we can reopen and resume worship at St. Mark's in a safe and prudent manner for the health of everybody. He's done a great job in guiding us. And so he's directed us during this month of May, while we continue online worship, to do a certain number of things. For example, we're going to have to develop a plan and develop the staff and the resources to be able to disinfect the church regularly between every service, so that when we do have services here, you can be assured it'll be safe for all concerned. Some other things we're going to be talking about this month is what kind of worship will it be, because we do need to give consideration to a new dynamic that's unfolding. We know we're going to have masks. We know we're going to have sanitizer. So there's a lot of that has to be worked out. And in order to maintain social distancing, we will not be able to sit together as closely as we have in years past. So one of the things we're up here this afternoon doing, we're going to take the tape measure out and measure the pews and measure how many families or how many people can sit in a pew, how far they need to be. Tim and the choir are going to be talking about can we put together an ensemble of two, three, or maybe a quartet of even four to be able to safely lead the worship. So there's just a lot of homework that we want to do, and we're excited to do it, because we want to continue to help lead this church in a safe and prudent manner and in a way that glorifies Christ. So I just kind of wanted to give you a little update about where we are. I wish I could tell you exactly when we're going to resume worship, but I can't. There's just too many factors involved that we've got to figure out. And we want to do this clearly in consultation with Bishop Larry. And because we're in Little Rock, and North Little Rock, and there are a lot of other Episcopal churches here, we're going to reach out and connect with all the other clergy in our Little Rock churches. And we want to coordinate and do this together. So as the church reopens on the campuses here in Little Rock, we'll all be walking together as one body in Christ, so that our ministries as we go forward will be in unity, because truly we all are in this together. So you'll be hearing from me again probably in 2 or 3 weeks, and I'm sure we'll hear again from the bishop, and look forward to working with all of you as we move toward coming together again on the campus at St. Mark's in some form. In the meantime, the blessing of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon each and every one of you.